Hello, this is Megha Pantre. Today we will continue with the second part of the chapter, What is Around Us? And our topic is atmosphere. The sphere of air that wraps the earth from all the side is called atmosphere. It extends approximately up to 1600 kilometers from the surface of the earth. It cannot be seen clearly with the naked eye like lithosphere, hydrosphere. Atmosphere is composed of various gases, water vapor, dust particles, smoke, salt, microorganisms, etc. Atmosphere is colorless, odorless, and transparent. Solid, liquid, and gaseous elements are included in the atmosphere. It contains approximately 78% of nitrogen, 21% of oxygen, and 1% of the other gases. When we go higher from the surface of the earth, the amount of most of the gases in the atmosphere decreases. As we move higher and higher, the amount of these gases decreases. Carbon dioxide gas is heavy, so it is found most in the lower layers of the air. And as it is heavier, so that is the reason it never goes higher. That carbon dioxide you will find on the lower areas. Ozone gases comprises of, now, ozone gas comprises of a very small proportion in the air. This gas absorbs the ultraviolet rays, and this gas absorbs the ultraviolet rays of the sun and protects the earth from excessive heat of the sun. This gas is more in proportion in the morning, in the open ground, and in the air near the sea. Gases like oxygen and nitrogen keeps the living creature on the earth alive. Nitrogen reduces the intensity of oxygen. Water is the most important component in the atmosphere. Due to heat, the water in the form of vapor evaporates and mixes with air, which is known as moisture. The process of cooling of vapor is called as condensation. Now, various forms of moisture like dew, fog, clouds, and precipitation are due to the condensation. The effect of atmosphere is seen on human being in every aspects of life, such as food habits, clothing habits, habitat, color, economic activities, etc. Most dust particles are seen in the atmosphere. And spreading of sun rays are visible due to these particles. It is due to the dust particles that it does not suddenly turn dark after the sunset, and it does not suddenly turns bright after the sunrise. The sun rays are reflected back with the help of these dust particles on the surface of the earth. The sun rays are reflected back with the help of these dust particles on the surface of the earth, and we receive light of the sun. We are able to listen the sound due to the presence of the atmosphere. That is why radio and Doordarshan telecast is possible. Now, the next part we will continue with is biosphere. The part of lithosphere, hydrosphere, and atmosphere where the living world exists is known as biosphere. Biosphere is one of the most important aspects on Earth. Earth is the only planet on the solar system having biosphere, because biosphere includes vegetation, animals, insects, and human beings. We obtain food and many other necessary things from biosphere. We cannot live without vegetation and animals. Biosphere is the base of our existence and living. It is divided into two parts, non-living and living. Lithosphere, hydrosphere, and atmosphere form the non-living part, while plants, animals, and microorganisms are included in the living world. So this is what biosphere is all about. Now, we will move on with the human being knowingly and unknowingly undertake many activities for their development. Human actions causes an imbalance in the different spheres. These are the human activities which causes imbalance in these spheres. Due to this, the balance of various spheres is threatened. Underground nuclear testing, too much drilling of mineral oil, drilling for mineral oil, and excessive drilling of tube wells affects the lithosphere and causes an imbalance. The dumping of waste from villages and cities along the industrial waste into the water bodies pollutes them. The polar caps have started melting due to increasing heat. As the temperature is rising, these glaciers are melting. The oil spills from ships and disposal of industrial and chemical waste into the water causes the destruction of marine life, which is highly dangerous for the hydrosphere. Harmful gases emitted by industries, workshops, power plants, and vehicles pollute the air. The areas with the higher frequency of vehicles show increased rate of carbon monoxide in the air. The amount of CO2 in the air increases due to the cutting down of trees. Heat on the earth increases due to increase in CO2 in air. In this way, human activities affect the biosphere, and this is how imbalance is being done. In this way, human activities affect the biosphere. The nurturing links of nature are endangered due to the exploitation of environment, which endangers the biosphere. So this is where we have finished with the explanation of this chapter, what is around us. And with the next chapter, we will meet in the next video. Thank you.